Last night, if you watched the North American League game between Oxygen Esports and Disrupt Gaming, then you might have found yourself in the middle of a Twitter firestorm, and trust me, that is justified. During the course of the match, Nyx from Disrupt Gaming was found to be using a variety of skins that are not currently whitelisted for competitive play. Some of them looked like darker variants of some seasons from Blood Orchid or Chimera, some of which haven't been allowed in competitive for over 2 years. As a result, the match had a lot of rounds called back over a multitude of rehosts, and stretched the game out a really long time because apparently the Faceit admins took forever to make a decision on what to do. In the end, it cost Disrupt several of those rounds, and all of their momentum on the first map of the BO3 had completely evaporated by the time play eventually resumed after the first rehost. When this happened, I was trying to find something of value to talk about in regards to the situation. At the end of the day, the skins themselves don't necessarily affect gameplay. Prior to Ubisoft's new North American League system, there were already a lot of skins that were banned from play under ESL, most of which pros never even owned as a result. Some of the names you might be familiar with are Ember Rise, Wind Bastion, the Twitch and Valkyrie Elite skins, and a couple of other ones, and there's a good reason for why they weren't allowed. But the use of the skins that Nyx had weren't particularly game-breaking or foreign, and I guarantee most people would not have batted an eyelash at this were it not for the rule changes on skins coming in a couple of weeks ago. The only headgear and uniform that a player can have in competitive games are any of the Pilot Program team skins, the white, black, and gold Pro League sets, and any of the skins that are going to come from the new Phase 3 of esports skins. And obviously the default skins are allowed, though I don't know of any pro that hasn't thrown money at their Uplay account trying to get Baroque Flair for the 15th time. When we got these changes, I think there was a massive sigh of relief from people who take the game seriously. We probably all have gripes with people who run certain seasonal or elite skins, which make them difficult to see against certain backgrounds or in older versions of the game in certain lighting situations. If you haven't seen any of those pictures of teams running full Ember Rise skins and blending into walls, then just be glad you weren't there in that match fighting against them.
This stuff is cancer in virtual cosmetic form. Why did Ubi even make these?
But if there was already a ban on skins before now, then why was Nyx running a different skin such a big deal? Because a big reason for these rules, aside from the obvious camouflage, is that it becomes difficult to distinguish which operator you might be facing unless you want to take a good hard look at them, and unless you're willing to spend more than the split second that it takes for them to show up in your sights, then you're probably going to have a much harder time relaying that info back to your teammates. You kill somebody on a really long angle, but they're running Wind Bastion skins? There's a chance you might not know which op you just killed. What's more is that pro players have to play with points on the right side of the screen turned off, and even that can still provide some intel. If you're Ella and you kill an enemy Zofia, you get a little sister rivalry score so you know who you got even if you couldn't tell what their player model was. Pros don't get that information, so everyone just got cut back to default skins and then the ones that are in direct promotion for things that Ubisoft can get people to buy from their store. When it comes to pro play, it's almost like some pro players have kind of formed a gentleman's agreement to say, well, we'll just run default skins because then we know exactly who we're playing and who we kill, that way we don't have the potential to miscall anything. I don't want to harp on Nyx too much, because at the end of the day, hopefully people can take the situation as a message to unequip all of your skins for competitive play. To his credit, he says he didn't intentionally have them all equipped, citing a series of Uplay cloud save issues on the new computer that he was using that resulted in the skins getting put back on without him knowing they were even there. People I've talked to have said this bug has happened to them before, so it's not an unreasonable explanation. It's never happened to me, but then again, the Maverick Reload bug has also never happened to— wait, never mind, that happens all the time. Personally, I agree with the new skin whitelist. It doesn't include changes to weapon skins or charms, so you can run basically whatever you want on those. And for the sake of simplicity and not heightening a chance of miscalling an operator you see or kill, I'd love it if it got added to ranked, or if Ubisoft would consider an option to turn off all skins in-game on a per-user basis. There are quite literally skins in this game that are considered pay-to-win because of the camouflage it offers. And most of them aren't available anymore unless you pull individual ones from alpha packs. But just the fact that they even exist is enough reason to question them in the face of competitive integrity. This shouldn't be complex, this shouldn't even be an issue, but if Ubi doesn't implement a cosmetic visibility option, then it falls on players and pros especially to hold themselves to a higher standard of competitive conduct. That's all for me, appreciate you guys being here. Please be sure to hit up my Twitter, my Twitch, and this YouTube channel for more in the coming days, please and thank you. And some of you have been asking when I'm ever going to get a charm on Twitch. The answer to that is 350 concurrent viewers, and I haven't even hit Twitch Partner yet. So, if you really, really want a charm that may or may not say BDST, I don't know. Twitch.tv/CaliberJacob. I might see you there over tonight. Have a good one. Peace.